All right, thank you for staying with us. It's still sports tonight, and we were taking your comments and, of course, dealing with your feedback when we went on that break. We'll continue in that light and take a few more comments on Twitter. Awofa Deji Olumide at Mide 82 says we should celebrate the record breakers, Aruna Kodri and Chiarika Okogu, no matter the outcome of their games.
Yeah,
all right, Aruna Kodri, some records there. And, of course, Chiarika Okogu, first time Nigeria has been rowing at the Olympics, participating in rowing at the Olympics, and she's already in the semis. All right, that's very, very encouraging. Joseph Dunku, our good friend who's watching us from the United Kingdom, says we need to look at other sports apart from the ones we're used to. We need to do our homework. That's exactly what Yemi was talking about. We need to begin to move, extend our frontiers into those areas that we never paid attention to, but we have people willing,
even if we don't have
the structures for them back home.
Yeah.
Once you have people willing to do it and can get their training outside of Nigeria, and they will do it and bring honor to Nigeria, we can always look at the bigger picture of those ones going ahead, actualize their dreams, and then come back to come and do something in terms of putting structures in place. All right. Oluseyi Owolabi says, we have a great pool of exciting young talents across Europe. Hopefully, the new coach of the Super Eagles will tap and maximize this. We'll talk about that as we go on the show. All right? And we can also tell you that the Super Cup game now, dramatic end to it. 90 plus 3 minutes, and Real Madrid are level. All right? So we are in added time. Real Madrid have drawn level. It's 2-2 now, and that game surely will be going into extra time. All right, is the UEFA Super Cup. The champions of the UEFA Champions League and the Europa League winners doing battle, all Spanish affair. Not a surprise that that game is going into extra time. All right, guys, a lot to talk about very, very quickly. And let's come back home to our issues. A lot of people have been waiting for us to start this. At last, the NFF have made it official. The German, Gernot Rohr, is going to be Super Eagles' technical advisor for the next 2 years at the minimum. There could be an extension, but then he signed a 2-year deal to be Super Eagles' technical advisor. Cosmos, they went about this differently from Le Guin. They went behind this quietly until this man got into Nigeria before anybody even got a hint that that's the new man.
Yeah, I mean, basically, they just showed that this is somebody that they wanted. They had to go for him. And, of course, a whole lot of us didn't even know about this appointment until when there were talks about the fact that the technical committee of the Nigeria Football Federation had already recommended him, and of course he came into the country. And also a lot of us might want to critically analyze his past antecedents and all that, especially with African teams, and the fact that the last time that he actually had any sort of relative success was probably in 1996, when Bordeaux got into the finals of the UEFA Cup at the time, and they played Bayern Munich in a two-legged final. They lost 2-0 and 3-1 respectively in that one. And they want to talk about that. I want to talk about the fact that he has coached some African side. First African side he coached was Etoile Desailly, was not particularly successful.
All right, hold on, Cosmos. Okay. Yemi, a lot of people are still saying that they're still in two minds, whether it was a good idea to go for a foreign coach or not, whether Samson Siasia would have been a good choice. Nigerians will always have this opinion going forward. But now that the NFL have come out to say, look, this is the man who will give him the environment, who will give him the support to do the job, I think all those arguments have to stop now.
To.
We all have to rally around this guy and help him to get the job done. And immediately, he has to hit the ground running. And that's why I'm happy that the Nigerian Football Federation have made arrangements for him to see the MPFL All-Stars on Friday during this tour of Spain that they're going to. So he begins to see firsthand the materials he has to work with to achieve results.
The only thing I can say in defense of Rohr is that I don't hold too much into people's past, you know. All of us said Claudio Ranieri was going to be sacked in 3 months.
Well, we're going to be the first one to be sacked.
He ended up being champion. So I really don't
and
care about
the ones
about
that we felt were going to win the title were sacked.
Didn't. So my point is, you can't shave a man's head without his consent. We might have ideas, but the NFF are the custodians of football in Nigeria. As much as some of us do not agree, I'm not saying I agree with the decision, but look, the decision has been taken. Where do we go from here? That's the question. So if you really love Nigeria, you're not going to pray for this man to fail. Exactly. You're going to pray that he succeeds. Yeah. You know, and leave anybody to brag and say, oh, it was a good decision. But that's not what really matters now. It will be a disaster. We've seen disasters in Nigerian football. But it will be a disaster that no one can describe in words if we do not qualify
for the World Cup.
For the World Cup. And it's big attacks already. And that is why I feel the NFF know that this one is enormous, and they have said, okay, this is what we want. Let's go in and give the man the free hand to do the job.
The environment, the support structure.
And
what would you advise? I mean, let's draw an agenda for this new coach. We've had foreign coaches here who have succeeded. Clemens Westhoff comes to mind. He's about the most successful foreign coach we've had.
Bonfrey
won the Olympic gold and silver at the Olympics.
Gloria.
Were you around during Auto Gloria?
No.
You were not around. I'm talking about in the recent past.
Okay.
All right. What would you be telling this man? The good thing already that we can see from what he has done so far is that he loves Africa.
Yeah.
He was ready to work here. He's ready to live here. He's ready to stay here and do the business. Get his hands into the soil. Get his hands dirty.
Yeah.
And really work. That's an advantage, because most of these Europeans don't really want the debt of the African game, but they love the money that comes with it. What are you going to be telling this man?
Yeah, basically, he just said it. He has the materials to work with. I mean, the MPFL All-Stars already in Spain are enough materials now, not to talk
and
about.
The Olympic team
and
also
the Olympic team
in
as
Rio.
Well.
So you can sit down and really watch.
Exactly. Now, so what it means is that he has a lot of materials to work with. He has materials in Europe, players that are in Europe. There's several players that are in Europe that are very eligible to play for Nigeria. And, of course, the ones at home. So the agenda for me is just to take each game as it comes. One game, not think about the future. Fine. They have given him a mandate. Qualify Nigeria 2 years. Qualify Nigeria to the World Cup. That is a mandate. He knows that he has to do that. But then take each game as it comes. I mean, these qualifiers is one of the toughest.
Yeah, I agree with Cosmos, everything that I said. But if you ask me, I also had that there shouldn't be 100% reliance on foreign-based players. Some of us still believe the reason we didn't qualify for the last Nations Cup was because you kept some boys in camp. And at some point, you allowed most of them go and left four. You know, so my own advice. I said it's my own opinion. That's what I said. I agree with everything that he has said, but what I'm adding
is that we should do more.
You should not rely. I'm not talking about quota system. A lot of people say that no, if you're good enough, whether you play for Calabar Rovers or you play for Barcelona.
I mean, Etebo was the home base when he played against Egypt,
and it was a standout
and scored
on that day. That's what. So there should not be total reliance. You should give equal chance
to the everybody.
And don't see them as training materials. Look, for instance, we say there's no money. Don't invite 35 players. If you know that you're not going to use them at the end of the
game. You can only use 11 plus 3.
It's a waste of time.
On the bench.
He talked about the MPFL All-Stars. He talked about, we know the league bloggers. There's an index. You can also look at who are the top performers in this league. Players you can easily invite based on current form and, you know, the local coaches around him. Then you can supplement. Because with the way football is run in Europe, where most of our players are based, the best you can get before any international match is four or five days. And those players will even come here and go and see their families first.
And then it takes the day, it reduces the number of days they have to work. All right? Final word on this one.
Another thing is this, and this is my final word. Even if he has all the best intentions for Nigeria, the Super Eagles and all, he still needs the support of the Nigeria Football Federation, come the sports ministry, to make sure that everything
works. It's not just those two.
Everybody
involved in Nigeria football.
Now, what it means is that we have to play in the best of stadiums. Now, you said you're going to be playing in Port Harcourt. Make sure that the stadium in Port Harcourt is in best condition. And make sure that everything, we do not want to hear, they do not pay this person, or there is rancor in camp and all that. As far as I'm concerned, everybody's hand should be on deck, especially the administrators, to make sure that everything is okay for this man to work.
All right, let's step down very quickly. One of the things that I will be expecting will fall in place for the new man are the quality of players we have on the domestic scene. And I'm happy that you get to meet these guys and see them at close range from Friday. I'm talking about the MPFL All-Stars, guys you've been following. Those guys have arrived in Spain. We are happy. They had their safe, smooth journey to Spain. And they're going to be playing Valencia tomorrow. About this time tomorrow, MPFL All-Star team will be facing Valencia in the first game of the tour. And how strategic is this partnership, Yemi? And how important is it for these boys to hit the ground running and post very credible results on this tour?
I mean, the new coach doesn't get a better chance than this one. I remember, I don't know if it was you or Inwuchia, I was asking about Obinna Nwobodo, and I was saying, is he as good? A lot of things. I've seen him a few games. And, you know, so he has the opportunity to really see why are people calling for these guys? Are they really worth it? Now you have the best, arguably the best players on the domestic scene in that one. What it does for you is they're able to pitch their wits against the best in the world. How are they going to fare? Are they going to have stage fright? Or are they going to stand shoulder to shoulder? And if somebody from here can stand shoulder to shoulder with players at Valencia, then there's no reason why those guys should not get a chance to play regularly for the senior national team. That's the advantage. And two, it helps psychologically. It also helps the players that, look, if I do well at home, nobody's going to look down on me. Why we're still waiting?
And the fact that Salisu Yusuf, the chief coach of the Super Eagles, is working with the team, is also some advantage for the Eagles.
Very true.
Because he's going to be in charge of the Chan team, and he's already getting to work with these guys, so he already has his work cut out for him.
It's not difficult for the coach. All he needs to do is make Salisu his best man, make him a good friend. Phone call, chit chat. You understand? Look, those top coaches we see in those clubs don't see those young players. They rely on the advice they get from the junior team coaches. Is this guy this good?
And the assistant coaches.
Once in a while, they go and watch the training. And, this young man you've been talking to me about. How good is he? Play him in this position. Let me see. Play him in that position. Let me see. Even without the player knowing that anything is happening. And the coach will be able to make up his mind. Although I feel for the coach. What do we want to do? Do we want to qualify for 2018? Do we want to build a team? Because it's always difficult.
So we want results, and we want them very quickly.
Yes, one result, and we also want to build a team. It is not a lie that we have promising players in Europe. You need to watch that friendly match on Sunday.
Yeah.
Three Nigerians, although one has decided not to play for us. But to see that a clubs of that size, and you have Nigerians getting on the score sheet, it's really heartwarming. But my fear is, will we be patient enough? That's why I'm happy that the new coach has got 2 years. I was hearing 6 months earlier, but now that it's 2 years, that is good. Some form of stability. How he's going to manage building a team and qualifying us? It's because nobody's going to hear that you're building a team, and that's why we didn't qualify.
So very true.
Experience and youth, the blend, and hopefully. But we do have exciting young players.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go on a quick break, our final break on Sports Tonight. We'll come back and wrap up on Sports Tonight. Join us again.